And how do you feel about the last shot that you got there?
I felt pretty good about it. You know, just trying to get the best shot up possible. It's funny because I was in that moment, I was kind of trying to decide whether I was going to go up with two hands and trying to shoot a jump shot or to a floater. And I just kind of last minute, I just switched it to a floater and I was able to get, you know, a good look and went in. You know what I mean? I really can't explain it. Just trying to get to a spot and rising up and getting the shot off.
And you struggled from the field for a long portion of the game. What's different about the past and now, knowing that it falls on you, and how you need to kind of continue finding ways or getting guys involved? Like, what is the process you're kind of going through as you're learning, you know, the relationship with DA?
Yeah, it's a new kind of mindset for me, just in general, knowing that, you know, I got enough time to get myself back in the game while, you know, taking initiative and trying to get everybody involved early. That's what I've been trying to do the last couple of games. And, you know, shooting the ball, it hasn't been working out well for me, but I think I've been happy with the progress, because usually in the past I would just fade that whole game and I just wouldn't be effective at all. And now, you know, obviously I got the ball in my hands a lot more, and I'm just trying to keep myself calm through those times. It can get frustrated when you're not making shots and you feel like you're not in a good rhythm where you think you should be, you know what I mean, in that time. And, you know, I just, you know, try to stick with it, you know, trusting that, you know, eventually the shot's going to fall. And today the shots fell at the right time. And, you know, that's what the coach has been preaching to me. Like, the end of the games, you most likely going to have the ball in your hands, and that's when all the best players, you know, regardless of how they play throughout the whole game, that's when they, you know, rise to the occasion. So, you know, like I said, I obviously shooting the ball, it wasn't the best night for me, but I was just happy that I closed out the game and was still poised and making good plays for others.
When you talk about, you know, getting more comfortable being the guy to close things out late, is that something that just comes with more reps? Or, like, how do you go about?
Yeah, it's just a matter of feel, like, you know, seeing what we need at a time. Like, every game is different. Like, I might not have. Like tonight, I didn't have really going, so I was just trying to find the best shot possible for myself or others. You know what I mean? Sometimes it didn't work out, sometimes it did. But as long as we getting good shots, quality shots each and every time that we feel good about. And sometimes I might have it going, and I'm just freestyle. So, like, I'm making shots, and it's time to go. You know what I mean? Just test and see how many shots I can make to finish out the game. But, you know, like I said, it takes, you know, trial and error, you know what I mean, kind of getting comfortable in those situations and understanding, you know, I've been here before, in this exact situation before, and I know exactly how to handle it.
And what were your impressions of Ayton tonight?
Nah, he was great, you know what I mean? You know, obviously, extra motivation playing your former team.
He denied it.
It's gonna be natural. You know what I mean? Whether he knows it or not, like, you know what I mean? I feel like it's always an extra motivation playing your former team. And so, you know, like I said, we made emphasis in getting him involved really early in the game and throughout the game, and that kind of boosted him up, and it boosted the team up, because he was just, you know, being dominant in the paint for us, and we was him in the pocket. They were, you know, sending two at me, and I was able to, you know, get them going through there, just find different ways to give them the ball, whether it was in transition duck-ins or, you know, in the pocket, like I said. And so, you know, that kind of got him going and was able to, you know, impact the game a lot for us.
How do you feel like you're adjusting to being the guy that teams are sending two at all the time?
I think I've been doing pretty well. I think for the most part, one thing I've been learning is, you know, just watching other teams and watching their guys, you know, play against, you know, it might be a different coverage or not. They just play the game. They don't overthink the coverage or not. And that's what I think I did in the past. And now I'm just playing the game. You know what I mean? Whether, you know, they send it two at me, I'm driving it, or just hitting the pocket, not overthinking it, and just playing the game and let everything, you know, take care of itself. And so that's why I think, you know, what happened to me before, I was just in my head about, like, they send it to him. What I do. And now I'm just, you just play the game. You know, if the shots are going to come to you, the pass is going to be there. You know what I mean? They're trying to send two. You either go past them or hit the pocket. You know, it's just kind of the same thing. And most of the teams don't change, you know, what they do in general. You know what I mean? So you just figure out ways to score within the game.
Was playing against Nurk, a guy who you've got that relationship with on the offensive end, he knows what you kind of want to do. Does that make the decision easier for you? Because he knows when you're trying to get to the outside. He rode you to the sideline a couple times, put the foul. But does that make it easier for you in the process, though? Like, I know this guy knows what I want to do, so I just need to simplify this process and make the right three.
Yeah, for sure. You know what I mean? Especially, like, early in the game, I saw that he was there a couple of times on the dribble around, and I was just like, all right, if he comes up, I'm going to just hit the pocket, or I'm going to try to get around, or hit the skip pass and just see what we get from there. You know what I mean? But there was kind of emphasis of trying to hit the pocket and making Nurk try to play both and helping DA, you know, get his shot going a little bit too. So, just trying to see where I can get away with against him that knows, you know what I mean? Like, you know, he played with Dame a lot, and I'm pretty much watched Dame my whole career too as well. So, you know what I mean? He pretty much knows exactly what we like to do when we come up pick and roll for the most part.
And would you say you're showing more emotion on the court or being more kind of emotive out there? Because it seems like you've kind of been a little more.
Trying to a little bit. You know what I mean? Trying to get some foul calls, trying to see if I can work the refs a little bit. But, it's just kind of trying. It's coming natural, honestly. It's not nothing I've been forcing, but probably the most animated I ever got was when I got that take in the Dallas game, and I was just trying to get the team going because we were in a rut, and I was like, I gotta do something. You know what I mean? So I just try to show a little bit of emotion, get the team riled up so we can, you know, get back into the game.
All right, thank you.
Appreciate it.